Welcome to Tekzilla Bytes, feeding your tech hunger fast. I'm Shannon Morse, and I've had lots of fun with my Raspberry Pi, but sometimes I need to make custom changes that are tough to do with the built-in config file. If you've run into problems with your display settings or inputs, PiCon might be the tool for you. First off, what you need. You'll need your Raspberry Pi, of course, with a 4 gig or higher SD card with Raspbian installed on it. If you don't know how to do this, use the incredibly easy to understand guide at raspberrypi.org, along with links to download. You'll also need some sort of mouse, keyboard, and monitor to hook up your Raspberry Pi into, as well as Ethernet to access the internets and download the PiCon installer. Normally in Raspbian, you have a config.txt file that you can use to configure whatever you need. Usually this works out just fine, but if you have a peculiar monitor or if your hardware settings are off, PiCon, aka the Raspberry Pi Configuration Manager, can help you out. It's a Java-based app available in the Pi Store. According to my research, this program will run cross-platform. It will create a new config.txt file that you can then save to your SD card with Raspbian installed, and upon your next reboot, your new settings will be saved. If you choose to run PiCon on your Raspberry Pi, it will run a little bit slow, just be patient, and it will eventually download and launch for you. In PiCon, you will see a bunch of different options. Here are some of the main ones. First off, there's video output controls, which let you switch between NTSC and PAL. You can change the aspect ratio, you can switch your overscan configs, enable a fixed frame buffer setting, and you can change HDMI display settings, such as 3D support, display, and boost. You can also force or disable sound, and even more. PiCon will also let you change the overclocking configurations for your CPU, GPU, and SD RAM. Now, if you'd like to use the advanced overclocking options, you can do things such as force turbo, change the GPU processor frequency, hardware video block or 3D block frequency, temperature limits, and so much more. My favorite part? Rotating the entire display to completely screw with my friend's Raspberry Pis, because who doesn't like a little bit of fun playing jokes sometimes? Like me. Now, if you do screw up your own Pi, just click Load Presets, which are the original preset defaults for PiCon. PiCon is an updated project, so if you run into any bugs, they will probably be fixed in the updated version. Sure, you could manually input all of this information into your own config.txt file yourself, but PiCon does make this a lot easier and it saves me a lot of time, so I like it. If you want to download the Raspberry Pi Configuration Manager, aka PiCon, it's a dollar and can be downloaded from the Pi Store. Now, try lynda.com for some excellent tutorials in coding for your own Raspberry Pi. They offer thousands of video tutorials for everything from motion graphics to web design, even Java. For $25 per month, you get unlimited access to video courses and you can start wherever you want at your own pace. So try lynda.com free for 7 days by visiting lynda.com/Tekzilla and get the skills you need to get ahead. For more from Tekzilla, hit up youtube.com/Tekzilla or tekzilla.com and share what you think below or tweet at Tekzilla. I'm Shannon Morse. Thanks for watching.